Hello, we are from Professor Liang's lab at University of Wisconsin-Madison. Today we are going to tell you some basic science about how crystals are formed through nucleation and growth. Crystals are everywhere in our daily lives. Let me show you some examples. People in Madison are quite familiar with snow. If you look at a snowflake under a microscope, you will find these beautiful ice crystals. And there are different types, different shapes, and different structures. The differences result from different crystallization conditions. Metals and stones are also crystals. These crystals have been engineered by nature for thousands of years, and some beautiful ones are further processed to be valuable gems and crafts. Most semiconductors are made up from silicon crystals, and that's why we call the center of technology in California at Silicon Valley. These valuable electronics are from the huge single crystal of silicon. Drugs are also crystals. Majority of oral drugs are in a crystalline form. Take ibuprofen for example. The tablet contains ibuprofen crystals grown from solution. Crystals are everywhere. Do you know how crystals are formed? In this video, we are going to use a hand warmer to demonstrate how crystals are formed through nucleation and growth. This hand warmer uses crystallization to release heat. The key ingredient is sodium acetate, which can be obtained by mixing vinegar with baking soda. What can we learn from this experiment? First, this is a hand warmer, and it's easy to see temperature jumps from 27 Celsius degree to 55 after crystallization, which means crystal growth releases energy. Second, crystal growth has two steps. The first part is called nucleation in size, and the second is growth. Without nucleation, this hand warmer will remain in the liquid state for a very long time. So we know the nucleation is essential to crystal formation. But when it crosses the barrier, the crystal growth is spontaneous. So how should we understand these two phenomena? Let's first talk about energy release. Why does crystal growth release energy? Let me use ice to explain it. Ice is crystal. As we know, when melting ice, it absorbs heat. And crystallization and melting are reversible. Therefore, ice formation releases heat. In physical chemistry, the reason is that liquid has higher energy than crystal at the same temperature. So when crystallization occurs, the extra energy is released as heat. We know water spontaneously flows from high to low, and so as energy. Since we know crystal has lower energy than liquid, the crystallization should also be spontaneous. But why does it need activation and an energy barrier to cross? Let's look at the beginning of crystal growth. Yes, crystallization lowers the energy of the whole system, but when the nucleation occurs, it will also form an interface with surrounding liquid. And the extra surface energy increases the energy of the whole system. So we have this plot now. Crystallization lowers the energy, while creating interface increases energy, which is unfavored to crystal growth. So the sum will first be positive and then negative. The positive part is the energy barrier. That's why the hand warmer needs activation to crystallize. In real world, nucleation can be achieved in many ways. For example, you can use a tiny crystal as a seed to grow crystal from melt or solution, or stirring, or adding impurity. Like snowflake, the nucleation is actually dust in the air. This is a basic science about how crystals are formed through nucleation and growth, and scientists are working on engineering the crystals in a better way. Let's go back to silicon. Electronics requires a very pure and perfect single crystal of silicon, which means the whole huge crystal should only grow from one nucleation. To achieve this, scientists have worked years to better control it, and the process is slow and expensive. Moreover, different conditions of nucleation and growth can generate different crystal structures. Here is an example of this small molecule. Starting from the same molecule, there can be crystal structure with different sizes, different shapes, and different colors. And that's why it's called ROY, red, orange, and yellow. In pharmaceutics, we pay a lot of attention on crystal structures because different structures have different properties, including mechanical properties, dissolution performance, and final adsorption into body. Sometimes, scientists do not want the liquid to crystallize, and if a liquid is cooled without crystallization, it will finally become amorphous solids called glasses, for example like window glass. Glasses are important materials. For example, some electronics are made into glasses and used in OLED. Cotton candy is sugar glass, and in pharmaceutics, some drugs are developed in a glassy state. In some cases, these glasses show advantages over crystals, and that's why scientists are working on better inhibiting crystal nucleation and growth to produce better glasses.